that.
Welcome back, Dark Souls fans, to Let's Die Horribly in Dark Souls 3, as you witnessed me do. Although, I kind of think that was... There were some weird hitboxes in that one, but anyway! Let's go to Disneyland! I think. That's close enough. Actually, it's more like the Disney logo! Let's go to the Disney logo! Actually, what did I just get? I got an item, Pontiff's Right Eye. What does it do? Boosts attacks as long as attacking persists. Knights who peer into the black orb are lured into battle of death, transformed into frenzied beasts. No wonder the Pontiff only provides these rings to those dispatched to foreign lands. Okay, so that kind of makes sense as a general concept. I gotta be honest, I do not like the Karthus Milk Ring. But the dexterity boost is a pretty sizable boost, and I don't imagine that this is going to be that much better of an option. Well, I'm curious, how heavy is the life ring relative? Oh, sheesh, that's heavy. I need to modify my armor if I want to wear that. Sheesh, that's below. I mean, I'm wearing big armor for the sake of avoiding that problem. You notice I've actually also... I'm also wearing the red armor, and we might also notice we are not in the lower area because, quite frankly, I'm sick of that. Maybe we'll go back to it later. I don't know, no guarantees, but I am, quite frankly, sick of underground chalice dungeon-y crap. It's been like that since... Well, I mean, it's also the Blight Town, I think. It's just so... Ugh. So disgusting. I'm sick of it. I want to change of pace. I want something nicer. I want to... What the... Well, okay. Am I loaded? I want to go with this one instead. Am I wearing both? Yeah, I am experimenting with both Pontiff's rings. So this is as opposed to the Karthus Milk Ring and the Life Ring. Oh, what?! Wait, that was not a painted world thing? I thought that was a joke. Great. So apparently this Moldering Lake is not an optional area, or if it isn't, then I maybe have to go up there because I noticed there's Lothric or High Wall of Lothric in the distance. And it looks like other castle-y bits, so maybe this area is just a place you go once you've found a doll, whatever that may entail. I don't know. Great. Just perfect. Where do I get a doll around here? Okay, I guess I've got to go back down to the Smoldering Lake. Maybe you beat the Smoldering Lake boss and you get a doll. Let's see if I can work anything out here. Alright, so that's death to go down to. And there's the upper area, which I can't get to. And that's the catacombs, which don't get me anywhere but where I was in the Smoldering Lake, which I guess we have to go back to. I mean, at least got rid of that thing, but that's all I gotta say, is ineffectual whining like that. Alright, back down to this Smoldering Lake, but I'm gonna go to the top area, because Where am I? Seriously, though, where am I? Is this the Smoldering Lake? No, this is how I got into the Smoldering Lake. Okay, wrong way. I almost should have just walked down here. But let's go down to this Smoldering Lake. As much as I'm not really becoming a major fan of the area, I guess we haven't got much choice. Alright, so there's crap over there that's shooting at me. Can I just dodge it by running? No, I can't. No, I cannot. I can dodge it by rolling. I can go behind some of the areas and... Oh, crap! A sandworm! I guess that explains the giant arrows is, you know, sandworms. Wait, electric sandworms? You've got to be kidding me. Oh yeah, you might also notice I got a couple more Estus. I had Estus shards. I got some Estus, basically I got Estus shards. I used up some of the large Titanite shards I picked up from here to upgrade weapons a bit. Where are my weapons? No, not you. That's the first item I ever had. Yeah, upgraded my longsword and crossbow a bit. And like I said, changed around armor a bit. They're bloody sandworms. I mean, seriously? Oh, wow, no. Ow. Okay, we're gonna have to be clever in fighting those. Ow. What the heck's that? Oh, nice. I believe speckled rings are resistant to everything, so great, I guess. What is a speckled stone plate ring? Let's look at it. Did I get that one? Oh yeah, I did. Stone plates are symbols of true knights, and speckled stone plates are granted to those who face an endless journey. Slightly increases magic, lightning, fire, and dark damage absorption. It's not that bad, actually. It's 4% for everything. That's pretty substantial. Remember, that's percentage absorption, so that's not bad. Anyway, so that's a thing. Not gonna wear it right now, but I will keep it in mind because make them handy. I mean, it's not one of those things that's super handy on its own because, you know, if you need resistances, you probably need resistances to a particular type of damage or a particular type of effect or damage. Oh wait, that's... Never mind, it's all types of elemental damage, not... Okay, I'm slightly confused. Oh no, giant enemy crabs. I haven't even dealt with the giant enemy crabs back where I first found them. Alright, so it's three arrows and then nothing. And then a short delay. Ow. And they're apparently terrible shots. Please let this be a doll. Chaos gem, no! And I don't need chaos weapons that badly or really at all. No, not giant enemy crabs! I don't know where its weak point is! How am I supposed to deal massive damage? Alright, well... Whee! Ah! You can know the drill. Oh no! It's the giant enemy crab! It's followed me! Thank goodness for Homer Bones. Alright. Alright, let's just go back to the bonfire that we were at in the middle of this moldering lake. Nowhere near the giant enemy crabs. I've gotta start fighting those at some point, I realize. Maybe for that area, I might want to get rid of the ballista shooting at me. That is actually my main goal. We know how to get there. Although it is a bit of a painful route, but we know how to get there. And that's about all I can say at this point, because other than knowing how to get there, there isn't much. And knowing how to get there is painful and involves cutting through these. Oh, hey, you stagger. Oh, right, and I gained... Okay, so I gained both... Oh, no, wait, no, crap. Back. That was not my Estus Flash, that was my Homeward Bone. Not what I wanted. Okay, let's try that with the Estus Flask out, and that'll hopefully work better. Hey! I hope you guys all like this area more than I do. I know I'm gonna have to get used to it. I realize. I mean, these are not as hard as the enemy I just fought, so... Wait, did I ever... I never used the souls for that! I might wanna do that. Like, actually maybe turn back to Homeward Bone and actually rest and use up souls, because... I have souls! Okay, I'll be back in a sec after I spend these souls. I totally forgot I was gonna actually get souls from killing a thing. I don't know why, but I did. Why, you might ask? Because I'm vain, that's why. We're back. I didn't actually have enough for a level and didn't really have much else I wanted to buy, but I was kind of had my eye on this thing for a while and I had a bunch of souls and I didn't need that many bolts, so... Actually, I could have gotten more bolts, kind of thing. Yeah, I could have gotten more bolts, but whatever. I can always get more bolts. So yeah, I have a ring that makes me look human because I'm vain. So a stack of rings ought to look nice, or actually, I don't know. I think I made a relatively attractive looking character. My avatar is, I think, pretty pleasant to look at. I think I mentioned this before. I wanted her to be, like, kind of attractive, kind of, like, pleasant, little bit softer features, and looking like she would kill you as quickly as look at you, because that's just how she is. Because she... Not again. Of course, I say that right as both a bunch of pyromancers and a giant ball of fire are trying to kill me. And are pretty much making a good and effective effort to do so. Let's go above. Ow. I never went up here, but I was always kind of curious. What? Yeah. Ow. Maybe I should not. Alright, so you're... kind of annoying. Wait, is that... No, it does not. Wow, they just make more of these things, huh? Please tell me it dies when you do. No! No, they do... Oh, they do. Never mind. Okay, good. Phew! Alright, that helps. You have Titanite Shards. Totally superfluous. They're money, basically. Honestly, they're like 100 souls each. So I basically get 2 Fading Souls every time one of those drops, because I do not need Titanite Shards anymore. I know these. These are Capra Demons! I knew something seemed odd here. Oh. Ow. Yeah. By the way, I also finally started binding my mouse buttons, side mouse buttons. I've got Logitech G400, so it has the back and forward buttons. Finally bound them. Was trying to do my normal first-person shooter thing of my forward button is use, but turns out it's a better roll button. So at this point, either thumb rolls. Which is kind of nice. It's a nice little thing to have. And then on top of that, I have the back button, which is my secondary. So it's a lot easier, because I was running into problems where like I hit... Because the way I have it bound, I have like ESDF for movement, A is my secondary attack, Shift is my primary, or secondary left attack, Shift is secondary primary left attack, Z is switch left weapon, Alt is two hand. So I get mixed up my pinky finger between all these things, so I just shifted up one of them to my right hand, to a button that wasn't being used, and that seems like a much better option. I actually had that binding in Dark Souls 1 as well, but Dark Souls 2 didn't seem to support binding those particular... Oh, nice! A bonfire! Awesome! Although, there are areas I haven't been to further down, but this is a nice place to have a bonfire. Anyhow, actually, come to think of it, this may be a better place to have a bonfire than I realize. Although, I still don't know where the ballistae are. Or the giant enemy crabs. I'm really concerned about the giant enemy crabs. I think I've adequately communicated that concern, but in case you weren't aware. Trio required... Ah! Of course, to be perfectly honest, I suppose I should be a bit more concerned about those. I mean, we were here before, last time, in a different one of these rocky cliff areas. And I was wondering, I wonder if that rocky cliff area over there is one that will lead me to the ballistae. I still don't know. Are you gonna shoot? Am I hearing sandworms? I'm hearing sandworms, aren't I? Okay, it is shooting. One, two, and three! Okay, good. Got time. Okay, we sort of have time. We have sandworms. We have sandworms everywhere. What's... Shield of Want. Okay, well, that seems appropriate. Given the circumstance... I will ride you one day. I will put my hooks in you and ride you. Just not today. But one day. Mark my words. Although, on the bright side, there's plenty of water. Alright. So I... Ah! Maybe I should actually bring the hooks with me. That would help. I'm getting a Shield of Wants, a Dark Souls 2 reference. I'm guessing everything that says Want is a Dark Souls 2 reference, because... Dark Souls 2, the final area where you're supposed to beat the game was the Throne of Want. It was a big thing about how Drang Lake was the Kingdom of Want, and that was all... It was all about greed and want. Where's the Shield of Want? I just want to get that confirmed. Or disconfirmed. Shield of Want! Shield of an ancient king who was cursed by an all-consuming thirst. In the end, he was no king. The residue of the king's lust still smolders within this shield, increasing the number of souls absorbed when the enemies are defeated. The skill is the weapon skill, which is kind of nice. So it is a covetous silver serpent ring in shield form. Should make sense given the name. Alright, so I think I lost my souls. But that was no big deal. I spent most of them. I got my human ring, so I'm vain. And kind of happy, but mostly vain. Never forget my vanity. Although I realize it's actually somewhat of a slightly humble thing to say. But, eh. Alright, alright. There it is. Ow. Oh, right. Sandworm. I probably would have gotten the message if I thought, oh yeah, sandworm. I've read Dune. I know that these things are, well, they're not actually sandworms, but they're... About this... Oh, I could have just waited. If I'd waited 2 seconds, that sandworm would have gone away and I would have been able to get through. Whatever, my greed killed me. Welcome to Dark Souls, where greed is death. Alright, whatever. Let's continue on. Good thing I didn't end her up first. Okay, so this is a boss. Maybe this will lead me up somewhere else. Who knows? Maybe it'll lead me to the stuff that's trying to kill me. What does message say? Time for ranged battle. I am ready! Alright, let's get an idea of this arena. Yeah, cover here. Whatever the boss is probably in the center. Nothing apparent from above. But it's really hard to tell. There's a lot of crap in the trees, so who knows what it would be. These are all demons. Stray demons, slash fire slash, that's asylum demon, that's Taurus demons. There's cavern demons on the ground. Is that a centipede demon? Old demon king. Well, that seems appropriate given the circumstances. Alright, alright, alright. You should know, I rather enjoy fighting team. Ah! Crap, think Fire Sage! Okay, whatever, we're fine. Ah! No, we're not fine! Now, it's foolish to think otherwise. Okay, so if it takes its hammer and stresses Lamb down, I know what's going on. So this is basically Izalith, Mark II. I still think Chalice Ascension 2.0 is a good title for the aesthetic, but there's a lot of demon stuff going on here. This is like, I guess it's supposed to be like a combination of all the different demon types except for Centipede. But, you know, Capra and Stray. I just call that one a Stray Demon, the one that was Asylum Demon, Stray Demon, Fire Sage Demon. I think Stray Demon is probably the most apt thing. Doesn't really have any other... It doesn't have a unique name, like a species name, like the Capra or Taurus Demons do. It's just Stray. It needs an owner. Adopt a Stray Demon today. But they make wonderful pets, or at least guards. Came out of range there. Ow. Bad. Alright, alright, alright. What do we got here? Ooh, nicely timed, me. Ow, poorly timed, me. Oh, that's actually a really small attack. Ow. Poorly spaced, me. Try harder. Actually, ooh, I want to know, is it weak to lightning? Yeah! It is not dragon. It is not super weak to lightning. Although, to be fair, that's actually a pretty fast way of attacking it, so maybe it's not that bad. Okay. Oh, I was trying to roll. That's a neat attack. Ah, darn it, me. I thought I was rolling. What the heck? Okay. I'm guessing there's a third stage, because that seemed to happen about... Actually, a quarter of the way through, so there could even be four stages. Alright. Alright, I think I'm kind of getting this boss fight. It's kind of a neat one. Although, I mentioned before that I think that the larger boss fights like that, where you can kind of avoid attacks either by dodging or by just being in the right place at the right time, that those are some of the best boss fights that Dark Souls can provide, given its combat system. Ow! Gotta figure out how to time that roll better. Alright. Ah! Man, why is spacing so hard to figure out in 3D? Oh, wow, that's a bigger explosion than I thought it was. As much as my previous comments of it being small. Oh, that's new. Okay, well, there may be some cuts starting now. Although, I don't know, because there's so many new things happening with this boss. I'm quite interested. I imagine that you guys still are too, because there's interesting new things happening. And the run back is really small. Like, there's almost no point cutting the run back just for how small it is. I appreciate this. All right. All right. I mean, I do have people say try a ranged battle, but honestly, it's definitely tricky. Ow. And it's definitely got stronger setup at short range. But I don't know. Ow, I thought it was staggering. That was a mistake. Ah, right, I gotta just roll. I like time the roll. It's pretty obvious that timing the roll is the only option. Like so. Okay. Oh. All right. I can deal with this. See? No problems. Of course, now it's super moded up. Ah, shoot. All right. It's just in the sky. It's no big deal. Ooh, not bad. Ah! Okay, that was unexpected. Ah, seriously? When are you gonna stop attacking? One more roll and I would have survived that. Okay, maybe I should try a lighter. I gotta remember to switch between the blades more often during combat. That's the way to go. But new stuff! This boss keeps surprising me. Throwing out new things. Some of which I'm able to handle, no problem. Others I have a bit of a harder time with. Wait, it's only 3 attacks to get the attack bonus? Huh. Apparently. Ow. All right. Don't want to be too far from that one, because it's pretty frequent that he then turns it into another type of attack. Ooh. Oh, right, this. Wait, was that stunned out? Could I have done a thing? Oh, this is the thing that... Oh, they target me! Okay. Ah, what? I gotta look where I'm going. Okay, so we learned a couple things. One, the Pondub's right eye triggers after the third attack. not the sixth attack like with the Pond of his left eye, and that fire is really annoying. I kind of wonder if the two rings work hand in hand, but I never really found the Pontus left eye to be that useful. Like, it's really disappointing. Pontus right eye, on the other hand, it's harder to criticize just because, I mean, it boosts attack power. So it's a win more thing. Yeah, whatever. No. If it works, it works. I mean, it seems to be doing some extra damage, kind of. It's hard to really judge, but damage is damage. There's nothing wrong with that. Oh, what? Ow. Okay, back to range combat. Alright, got it. There we go, behind it. Which is usually the safe option. In front of it, however, is not the safe option. It's very, very strictly behind it is the safe option. Oh, right. Oh, it's a matter of time. Okay, that makes sense. Okay, expanding out. And that was purely expanding out. Ah, shoot. Didn't roll in time. All right. I'm good. Got this. Is it outside or inside? It's inside to outside. And no further. Now I got a tail. I can't cut it. What the heck? Darn it! Should have rolled more. I was hoping I'd be able to time the roll, but I'm just finding, for some reason, that's why I put it on the mouse button, because spacebar is taking a little bit too long to press and release. It's killing me a lot. It was killing me a lot during that first fight, during the fight against the big beast thing, the Bloodstarved Beast, whatever it was. I don't know, it reminds me of the Bloodstarved Beast. I mean, there's no input lag or anything. Oh, shoot. It's not a question of input lag. It's actually a question of just, I think I'm trying to do it on the frame, and the game is not really built around reaction rolling. Like, if it were, it would probably be the case where if you rolled, like if it registered the roll input on the frame that you'd be hit, you would not be hit. Like, not even an input delay thing, but, like, input delay, the compensation for that one frame of input what the heck? Like, compensation for the one frame of input delay that's inevitable, because the way input works, would be that if it's like, oh, you release on the, like, if you, not release, but if you go into a roll on the frame, you wouldn't be hit. I don't know if a lot of games do that, but it seems like it'd be a way of compensating for input delay. Like, if you rolled on the frame, you'd get hit. It was like a perfectly timed roll. So your roll and the attack would happen on the same frame. Because I don't know, I feel like that's the only reason I've been getting hit for a lot of these, is because I've been rolling on the frame rather than a few frames before. Oh, what? Oh, sheesh, how do you dodge that? I wonder if people were saying, prepare for range combat. We're kidding. Ah! Especially when the rolling is not working for some reason. And I can't seem to get behind it. Okay, now I'm behind it. There we go. Ah! Well, it's not even that's not working, it's just that the way that Dark Souls rolling works, it's really tricky because you are not, you're rolling on a release, not on a press. And in most action, third-person action games, Which, I mean, I know I've argued that Dark Souls is not really much of an example of that, but it's one of the things it does. Most, it's on press. Like, basically anything by Platinum, and Platinum is all about dodging. Like, Platinum games, if you want a game where dodging is the game, play a Platinum game. Devil May Cry, Bayonetta, doesn't matter. I've actually personally only played Bayonetta. Awesome game. But, yeah. Dodging on the press. I mean, actually, that game is super about dodging because it has the dodge offset techniques and everything. I don't know if DMC has that. Well, any Devil May Cry game, I should say, has that. But Bayonetta certainly does. All right. Okay. There we go. Ah. Rolled a few frames too early. Probably should ember up before the next time I do this. Oh, wait. Oh, wait, I got free hits. I don't have very many free hits. Let's go. Just dodge the meteors. And then dodge the row of fire, I guess. We're ranged combat now. Okay, it's expanding. Okay, are you gonna do another attack? What the heck? It really is the release thing. It's so annoying that rolling is on release and not on press. If it was on press, say press the button right as that happened. Why do they have to make rolling on release? It just seems weird too, because I mean, if you think about it, yeah, okay, you might say, well, yeah, Dark Souls is on consoles, so you want to roll on release. It's like, well, I mean, like, you don't have that many buttons. It's like, no. Because the sticks are each buttons. And there was no system the game was released on that didn't have support for pressing the stick down. So that's really not an excuse. Especially since with Dark Souls 2 and... Oh, wow. Ah, darn it. Dark Souls 2 set it up so that you... Ah, good. As I was about to say, in Dark Souls 2, they set it up so that if you press the left stick while running, it caused you to jump. So I was like, why not just set it up so that that was your run in the first place, and then B is just roll. Or not B, but... Well, in the Xbox, it's B. On the PlayStation, it's circle, I think. Whatever. People who play on console know what I mean. But I just find that really weird that there was no button for run. Or, like, run and jump being on the same thing is kind of weird, but to be fair, the semantic functionality of the system is such that run and jump are on the same thing. Ugh. So much for that ember. But yes, the semantics of it are that run, you have to run to jump. So that makes sense that run and jump are on the same button. But having roll on that same button, that doesn't make sense to me. Well, roll and backstep on the same button. I mean, jump can be separate, but not roll. And it's like, why not just... Why didn't you just have run be on pressing the button down like pretty much every other third-person game? And then have dodge be hitting what is now the combined movement button? Like, one might argue, okay, but Dark Souls is not a game about rolling. You're playing challenge run. And like, okay, yeah, sure, fair enough. But Bloodborne didn't do that, and Bloodborne is all about rolling. So that's not really an excuse. I don't really buy that. How did that hit me? Oh, God, these hitboxes. They get later and later in the game. The hitboxes get worse and worse. Like, that was the back of its stick. It didn't even touch me. Sheesh. Same thing with the other boss, too. Not the boss, but the thing before the Earth of Laboreal Valley. There were so many times I was like, I'm in the middle of your body. You didn't bite me. Starting to think maybe I should just put the life ring back on. You know, I noticed if targeting wasn't taken away from me every second. It's like every second attack, targeting's taken away from me. I get, you know, they're kind of far away. Oh wow, I can stagger these things? Oh crap. Ah, how do I avoid that? Alright, gotta use that attack pattern at least. Let me get behind you. Man, you're annoying. Alright, is it gonna not do anything for a little while? Okay, good. I can heal. Oh wait, this is fire ring. I thought I could dodge that. What the heck? Oh, I dodged into the fire ring. Well done. Well done, me. Okay, alright. We survived. Ah. Oh, making more meteors. That's why. I think here... Okay, good. I got it. Okay, are we going for... Nope. Out. Out to end out. Crap. With meteors! Actually, this is probably the easiest way of dealing with this stuff. Because I can just roll and roll and roll and roll and not get hit. Because rolling this game is actually pretty ridiculous. Like, there's apparently like 28 frames or something of roll invincibility? Something like that? Okay. Jump over, and then meteors. Okay, perfect. Meteors with fire, I can live with. Or live through, to be more precise. Ow, what? That actually hit me through a roll? Wow. And that's going to be probably going out. Nope, that's... Ah! Out to end out again? Crap. Okay. Ah, what? How did that hit me? I'm so dead. Okay, goods. In to out. I think I'm far enough away it won't matter. I miss. Okay, this is out to end out. Okay. All right, am I far enough away? No, shoot. What is far enough away? Okay, I think that's in, yeah, it's in doubt. All right, that's fine. I was far enough away. Ah, shoot. Oh, come on. Thought I'd have that one. Okay, now I'm starting to lose my patience with this boss. But yeah, apparently Dark Souls 3's roll is really powerful. At the same time, it's just... Like, it's not as far from broken, because the entire game feels like it's relying on you to do it, you know, a few frames in advance of when you're supposed to do it. But there's so many things that are, like, on the frame type things, where, like, if you don't, like that. I'm supposed to predict that. Oh no. Shoot, stupid attack I can't deal with. But yeah, like, how am I supposed to predict that? That fireball is so fast that you have to react to it. In order to react to it, you need to have, like, 20 frames in advance to be able to react to it and process it. And on top of that, there needs to be no additional delays. And the fact that you have to release the bloody button is such a pain in the butt. I wonder if Bloodborne's that annoying, too. Oh, I think that's a visceral attack timing. Oh, seriously? Seriously? Okay, now that was probably when you could do a visceral attack. Or critical attack. I know, I'm gonna use Bloodborne terms, despite having not played that game. I'm gonna use Bloodborne terms constantly when that comes up, but... Okay, I got a good feeling about this one. Good enough that I am going to use an ember on it. Just need to not get hit by the... Ah, that! Just need to not get hit by that. Well, whatever. It's really hard to do that anyway. I mean, it's really hard to get the heal during that fight anyway. All right, I can hit you. It's kind of funny how I find Dark Souls 1 to be one of the easier games to do this kind of run in. And Dark Souls 2 would have probably been fine if it weren't for the fact that rolling and imp delay attached to it. Like, if it weren't for the imp delay on rolling, Dark Souls 2 would probably have been okay for this kind of build, but 3, despite the fact that it feels like it's designed for this kind of build, I think because it's designed for this kind of build makes it really, really hard, because it's not real. I think it's, like, designed, I almost feel like it's designed against this type of build while being designed for it. Like, it's designed so that this build feels like it should be right, because, you know, this build's all about speed and such. Great. I'm getting hit by all the attacks and I have no... Nope! Oh, why'd I do that? I thought I was doing a big thing! But yeah, it feels like Dark Souls 3 was designed with this build in mind to completely crush it. Or to make it part of the game without really totally testing it to make sure that it completely works. I mean, yeah, okay, rolling is strong, but... Oh, crap. But it's also still on press, so you still have that delay of releasing. It doesn't matter if you're using a controller or a keyboard or a mouse or whatever, you're still having to release a button. But even though there's basically no input delay, which there isn't, I tested it. I've been testing it recent with this stuff, too. It's like, no, there isn't... There's no perceptible input delay, it's just that it's not input delay, it's that the entire input method is inherently delayed. Because it's on a release. Shit. So close that one time. attack. Hitting. This sword does more attacks? No, it's not. Hey, I dodged it without looking! Go me! Ow! Didn't dodge that one without looking. In fact, I'm in a lot of trouble. Okay, so that's lava circle. Okay, I want to be right here so I can dodge it out of their way! Oh, crap. That. Thankfully, it takes a while for to get the fireball going. Ah, what? Shoot. This boss is so annoying. This boss and the last one really exposed the weakness. I'm saying, it exposes the weakness of the rolling system. Actually, this boss isn't even so bad. It was the other boss that really exposed it. This boss doesn't expose it so much. I just got on my head because of the big Bloodstar Beast boss. Which did a lot, because there's a lot of things that were basically reactable. But it's only reactable if it was on press, not on release. I'm just kind of curious how much delay that adds having to release as well as press the button. Like on average. Ow. Shoot. Well, I mean, it's not so bad if I just do this every time. Okay, there we go. You gonna do something, huh? Ow! Oh, you're gonna do that again. I can't see what you're doing. Oh, good, I got the spacing just right. Oh crap, I don't want to be too close. Alright, I can avoid this, no big deal. Is this the one where he does? No. Okay, it's Lava Ring. Which one are we doing? Outside. Okay. Ah, what? I guess wasn't moving when I dodged that. Alright, it's no problem. Just slash away at the thing. Oh, crap. It's always something. Oops. What am I expecting here? Okay. There is room to go back to, so I can avoid that by just backstepping out of the way. Ah. Alright, which one's this? Inside or outside? Inside, alright. Inside's much easier to deal with. Oh, wait, what? Oh, what? Hey, I got out of there. Whoa, that missed? Oh, it takes less damage during that summoning period. But, come on, pile of demons, save me! Okay, that's an expanding one. I should call into out because I couldn't remember the word expanding in the middle of a heated fight. My addiction kind of goes when I'm in the middle of these fights, so bear with me. Okay. This is going to be coming in. Ow, what? That still hit me? It's moving. Although, in means into out. Contracts, then expands. I remember words now. Alright, other pile of demons, save me! Thank you, pile of dead demons! Never thought I'd say that, although admittedly, the best demon is a dead demon. Oh, wait, this is the explosion, I don't want to be anywhere near. Okay, now it's vulnerable. I don't know where to hit it, being it's vulnerable, but I could probably just swing! 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 Yeah! It swung! I killed you! Good fight, let's have another. Hey, I got my member back, awesome. Alright, cool. Hey, 25k souls, maybe I should get the tower key. Like, I feel like I should get that tower key. Maybe that gives me the doll. Maybe the doll's in the Cemetery of Ash. You know, maybe the doll's in the Cemetery of Ash, now that I think about it. Hang on a sec. Is there a way out of here? Like, up? This was a dead end, wasn't it? I was expecting a path out of here to get up to those ballistae. I see no such path. Well, anyway, that's... I think gonna be the... Well, I don't want to end right here. I mean, this is not a bad time to end, but you know what? Let's see what's in that tower. At least, open the door. And let ourselves in. Maybe we'll find a doll. Maybe that doll will be of some use. Maybe not. Who knows? I mean, actually, we know if the doll will be of use, because then we can go to Disneyland.
Ah.
I want your tower key, because maybe it'll get me to Disneyland. Actually, do you have a doll? You wouldn't have any dolls in your possession, would you? No, no you don't. Alright, tower key it is.
Ashen brick, is it?
Yeah, yeah, you're good. Alright, cool. Actually, you know what? Well, I'm here. Huh? I need bolts. Actually, you know what? No.
Ashen.
This is a nice round number, and for all I know, that there's something more for this. A ring or something. I mean, it's a demon soul. Maybe we got something to give her a demon soul. Yes, I did. And let's see. Soul of the Demon King. There's a pyromancy. Ooh. Traces of the tumultuous seabed that birthed the beings known as Chaos. Hurls Chaos Flame. Demons born from the fire bore its smoldering essence and perish soon after. Yeah, because, you know, Dark Souls 1 main character killed them. Man shares this rapport with the flames to this day. But my Dark Souls 1 character didn't kill them all. Certainly did her college best, though. Alright, where is... Anything I can do with... No, nothing else I can do. Other than... Actually, that's not a soul of a demon? Huh. Okay, well, whatever.
No.
Single pyromancy, not a big deal. Anyhow... Rah, in that case, I'll just... I'll eat the soul. Yes, use soul of the old Demon King. I don't need it for any item. What? I don't have quite enough? Oh. Hang on. Let's check something. Strength of 21. Alright, 3 levels away! And I only have a few. Yeah, there's not enough. What do I need? Like 16,000? Yeah, 16,274. Well, anyway, up we go! Or round, or where do we go to get up to the tower? Go up here. I believe there's a zombie dog. And then we wait while the gatekeeper lets us through, prepares the ride so we can go. Oh wait, that's not Disney. We're not in Disneyland yet. My mistake. One day. Okay. I wonder if I'm the only person who calls it that. You know, come to think of it, behind the Cemetery of Ash, there's that giant castle there. I wonder what that means. Oh, there's the tower. Oops. Oh, right! I can't go this way. There's an alternate route that I have to go up some stairs inside Firelink Shrine to get to it. Yeah, another Fading Soul. Forgot, there's another route. I'll get to that. Might cut it. And what is the tower? I'm not gonna be that cruel. I'm gonna look right now. Well, it's a tower. It's... Oh. Well, this does seem like a good place to stop the episode. So I'll see you on the next one. And I look human again! I sit down.